last application continued from December 9, 2014 and January 29, 2015. Debbie LLC doing business at Studio Mantra. Sarah Jeet, Padla manager for transfer of the all alcoholic beverage restaurant license currently held by F&E Restaurant Corporation. Ronald Holland manager. Proposed hours of operation are 11 a.m. to 1 a.m. Sunday through Wednesday and 11 a.m. to a.m. Thursday through Saturday and a proposed seating capacity of 82. Applicant is also applying for a change of location from 21 Brookline Street to 577 Massachusetts Avenue. Pledge of license and an entertainment license to include the dancer by patron, live music with the amplification, DJ, audio tape machine, CD playing music below at or above conversation level, and 6 TVs.
Good evening, Madam Chair. I'm members of the commission. My name is Attorney John Aieta. It's J-O-N-A-I-E-T-A. From Haas and Kayer, each in Russell Park in Quincy. Here representing Dougie LLC with me. That's my immediate right is Sarge Pavla. Sarge is the 50% member manager of the LLC, as well as the proposed manager of record. And to her right is Anish Ronda. He's an employee of the LLC. He's going to be acting as a supervisor of the role.
And if you could please spell those names, please, so
sure.
We can have them for record.
Sarge is S-A-R-A-B-J-E-E-T. Pavla is spelled P-A-V-L-A. Anish is A-N-I-S-H. Rondev is R-A-M-D-E-V. Is that all right?
Right.
Okay. Yeah, Madam Chair, this is continued. Last time we spoke, it was concerns or questions of the commission relative to the size of the kitchen, which serviced the first floor, only located in the first floor. Since that time, we have gone to an architect, designer, and resubmitted floor plans both for the first floor and second floor. Hopefully, we may have those in front of you. If not, I do have additional copies as well.
We have additional copies at the
floor. Okay. In addition to that, there was some clarification on paperwork just to, for purposes of disclosure. Sarge Pavla is a director of one of the corporations that does hold the liquor license. Which she just was involved as of last year. So we wanted to update the board on the application form as well as any of the personal information forms. To that end, I did realize the manager application also does ask about any prior ownership in an entity that owns a liquor license. So I do have a revised signed manager application I would like to submit as well. On top, I've stapled the packets. Actually, I'll keep the paper clips so I make it easy. The top portion of the floor plans, the documents behind are the documents I just spoke to regarding the change. With the floor plan, that, as I discussed, so the first one you're looking at is the first floor, which is at 577 Massachusetts Avenue. The to the right is Shalimar Indian Food and Spices, which is a retail shop. In the back portion of that right-hand side is Dosa Factory, and that is the kitchen space that is currently in existence and also to be utilized, the second floor space. I'll talk more about that. That's approximately 350 square feet. The second page is...
Excuse me.
Yes.
Interrupt you for a minute. So,
that's Mass Avenue.
This is Mass Avenue.
Correct.
This is the existing liquor store, is it?
That's Libby's, yep.
Libby's. So?
The other one that says existing store is Shalimar Food.
Okay. And you mentioned that when you referred to Dosa Factory, that's this little...
That is the seating there, yes.
The elbow in the back?
Yes.
Thank you.
And again, for clarification as well, we've gone back. I think last time I mentioned Dosa Factory had 45 seats. It's actually 36 seats. And I know that was a concern as well as in terms of the total number of seats and what the kitchen can service. The larger changes, renovations take place on the second floor, which is the restaurant space. So that is, should be hopefully the second page in the packet there. There's stairway that is leading up to the second floor in existence. Also proposed is a new elevator, which is right off that area. If you come up into the restaurant space and into the dining room, there are booth seats. Initially, it was proposed to have 82 seats. With the restructuring of an additional kitchen preparation area, we've eliminated 10 seats. So actually, the seating in this space, second floor, would be 72 seats, which would include 56 table booth seating and 16 at the bar area. The new kitchen area is approximately 150 to 200 square feet. That is in the back portion. It should be entitled kitchen preparation area. There's also an area for liquor storing as well. Within that area, there are two dumbwaiters, which would help bring not only the food from downstairs for the hot items, prepared items, but also a way to move the dishes and things like that and facilitate that. Upstairs, as I mentioned, it's still a significant amount of space upstairs, which would be a service area, preparation area, plating area. And it took great lengths to find the appropriate size and space in this. They feel that this is very confident. This is going to help relieve and alleviate any concerns that the commission has and certainly make it a workable space for the restaurant. I think also the elimination of the 10 seats is going to reduce the overall patrons, and that would help, as well as the correct numbers on the dose of factory below. So that's reducing by 9 seats as well the amount of patrons that would be servicing and using that kitchen space. It's going to be a complete rebuild. They are going to, it is their intention as well to install a fire suppression system, even though they are underneath the 100 seat requirement. They want to make this a modern space and have it really nice, clean, modern dining experience. Again, as a reminder, that it was it's French cuisine with Indian influences. It's tapas, small plates, so therefore it is a different style of service, and therefore the dual kitchens they feel would be they'd be able to accommodate that without any problem.
You mentioned an elevator, right?
Okay, so it says new lift platform. It's let's see which way you're holding it. Yes. There's also the main egress in and out through the stairs is also a rare egress to the back of the building from the second floor.
The stairs for the, I'm assuming the stairway for patrons to enter is that front stair.
That would be the main stairway for patrons to enter.
The back stairway will be emergency egress.
That is correct. And the third page again is a kind of the elevations, front facade, as well as what the proposed facade would look like.
Yeah, Libby's is staying there?
Staying there, that is correct.
I'm a little curious about how do people access the law firm?
The stairs going up, there's a little hallway. So there'd be a entrance into the dining area and a hallway down to where the law office is up. There's like a double door. If you come up the stairs, there's a hallway all the way around to the back staircase.
So I,
you would enter the restaurant.
You're going to come up the stairs.
Yep.
To the second floor. If I'm going into the restaurant, I guess I'm going to take a right.
You would take a right to the
and
right.
Then another right.
No, just
that's
one right.
Just one right through the double set of doors, and you're into the restaurant area. If you take the elevator up, it would have direct access into the restaurant area. There's a little vestibule or welcome in the area. There's a hostess, our host table.
Is that hallway for the law firm, is that going to be secured after hours? After hours for them?
Their area will be secure. Is that what you mean for the...
Yeah, so...
There's a liquor storage and the... I put in long hours. I don't know if they'll be up to 1 or 2 a.m. in the law office, but yes,
right.
The restaurant itself would be completely locked off, secured. So,
what I mean is somebody comes up those stairs, you don't know whether they're coming into your restaurant or they're going to walk down that hallway trying to get into one of those law offices. Is that correct? That's just my...
Right. I mean, and I think as far as we've spoken to the landlord, and I think they're going to be moving their offices from there eventually.
Okay.
But we don't know that for a fact. They might.
And if for some reason they did move, does that mean you'd be looking to expand your space even more?
I've not been decided.
Remind me of the seating capacities being used here.
Sure. So the original application had 82 seats. There's a booth towards the end where it's presently now identified as liquor storage. That's being removed, so that's 10 less seats. So it'd be 72 seats, 56 at the booths, and 16 at the bar.
And the standing capacity is still going to be, what does that say, 78?
I don't know. Yeah, that's misidentified, I think. I don't know whether 78. Okay, yeah, they've got listed 160. It's probably, they have it here, 66 seats. They didn't reduce the 10, so it should actually be, the 78 would be standing, should be 150 for a total, I think.
Right, so 16 at the bar, 56.
Correct.
In so booths, 78
standing.
8 standing, 150.
150. Give or take about 2,800 square feet.
Assuming that the law offices stay, how do you propose to be good neighbors? Because I assume if someone's there late at night working and
absolutely.
You have music going, how do you propose to be good neighbors?
They intend to have as much soundproofing as they can install. I think the best thing is just to, it's no surprise that they're going in here, but they want to be good neighbors there. We'll try to work with them. Obviously, if there's a function, event, party type of thing, they would put them on notice well in advance if there's any problems. I'm not sure exactly what type of law they practice, but talked to the landlord about this?
Okay. Well, the landlord's daughter is the one who occupies the offices, and she's been notified that we're in the process.
She's
with
you for
I was sure the
language. No,
no. She's only in the premises until 3 or 4 o'clock.
Yeah. Yeah.
Is the ownership of this proposed Studio Mantra the same as the ownership of the location that was previously in Boston?
Yes.
So it's my understanding, when the Boston location was open, there were several instances of disciplinary actions. Can you explain to us how the management of if we were to approve this, how the management of this location would be different from the management of the location that was in Boston?
To begin with, I think that the space that we had in Boston was much larger. It was almost three times Mr. Speaks, and we have too many people that was in there most of the times, and I think we're going to make it more. It's not going to be a nightclub like the one we had in Boston. So it's going to be more or less like a small play, a little dance floor where you can have about 10 to 15 people who can dance.
Different
concept.
What was the location in Boston?
52 Temple Street.
And you're saying your claim is that that was more of a dance club?
It was more of a restaurant, and then it would turn into a dance club.
In other words, after patrons, after dinner service, it turned into more of a nightclub atmosphere, and that's not their intention, obviously, for this location.
But in this location, it would have a DJ and a dance club.
Perhaps. It would be an occasional. They would like to offer that for the lounge type feel. Again, I think we discussed jazz music with different DJs as well, to bring in and have a contemporary play to the establishment.
I'll let the record reflect, I'm reviewing pages that we received from the City of Boston Licensing Board docket sheet as it related to the Studio Mantra that was located on Temple Street, Temple Place, 52 Temple Place, Unit 1. It was a license type, was a CB, a 7-day all-alcoholic beverage license. And it's pages. And some of the descriptions, in my opinion, are somewhat troubling. So I guess that's why I'm just looking to make sure that we're not talking about the same type of establishment. Some of the incidents that are noted, large fight involving patrons, two were minors, employees on premise drinking after closing hour, patron found unconscious outside. Several incidents of suspension. So I just want to make sure I get a better understanding in terms of.
Right. I think in that instance, the atmosphere, location was an issue. They've gone a completely different turn in this instance. This is intimate dining. It was top of small plates. It's not going to be a nightclub crowd. It's not going to be a rowdy or loud crowd. It is. Sit down dining, there will be some music, background music, there will be a chance for dancing, DJs, but it's not a situation that's going to lend itself to a nightclub feel at all. I think they can speak to that. I think what happened was in Boston, to the best of my understanding, is the size of the space, they tried to utilize it as much as possible. They realized you can't have a restaurant for all the hours in Boston at that location, but besides, and they felt that they could also incorporate a nightclub into that, and that's kind of what it came and turned into, and that's certainly not what they're going to do at this location. So I think, in a way, they're a victim of the size and of the location. This is a very small, intimate space. They have their other businesses downstairs. They're certainly not looking to jeopardize that or to bring something else that's unsavory into the location.
What is the timeline of the establishment in Boston? How long ago was this?
Well, we shut down the business about 3 years ago.
And how long was it in operation?
Roughly about 10 years.
10 years, and it's been closed for two?
Correct.
And have you been operating a restaurant since?
Yeah, we have other entities that we're running there.
And they are located where?
Newbury Street in Boston, Tremont Street in South Bend, Center Street in Jamaica Plain, Davis Square.
this is the family as a whole, and they're, you know, it's not all the same, exact same ownership structure, but it is, you know, it is interrelated, they work there, they supervise there, so it is, they are all accountable to those groups. Sarabji is currently running Dosa Factory, along with Elminda, the other member manager, which is at this location in the first floor. And that's the Indian street food. And therefore, that was the idea. The whole came from that to expand. Dosa Factory, there's only so much expansion you can do. The second floor became available, and they decided to do this, you know, fine cuisine, French cuisine, Indian influence, to really have a different flair for the city.
Hmm. Yeah. We're actually looking to bring in a specialty chef from India, who's a very well-known chef, to be the chef at the restaurant. So.
The focus will be food again. That's for another day.
Who was the manager at the 52 Temple Place?
He is no longer in the company.
So he will be coming after this?
No.
I think one of the things that kind of concerns me is, and I appreciate you saying that this, the intent here is not to be a nightclub, but to focus more, I think you used the words, on intimate dining. But what troubles me somewhat is the presence of a DJ booth and this big open floor space that's prepared to read. I want to say it's, this looks like it's going to be about 20 feet by 8 to 10, somewhere around there. So I mean, that's
probably, it could be 100 to 150 square feet, maybe, for
that's
our dance area.
That's a pretty big, wide open floor area.
Well, again, if we're going to have dancing, it's going to be some area we're not bumping into other patrons.
I agree, but that's my whole point, is that
it's probably this side space here, is my guess. It's probably, so it's not, it's 150 feet. Probably a 12 by 12. That's probably
this is about this is about 15 across by,
maybe from where I'm sitting back, but it's probably not much larger than this. I mean, you have to have some open area anyways for people to get in and out from the bar area, from the booth area. There is a DJ booth. They just wanted to dedicate an area. If there is a setup, if there's a jazz musician, if there's an act or anything like that,
Are you putting in, you know, for lack of a better term, dance lighting and so forth? Or?
No, there's no dance lighting.
Yeah,
who's the manager of record? Who will be the manager of record?
Sarabji will be the manager of record. And she has close to 20 years experience in the restaurant business, retail business, and is currently operating and running Dosa Factory, which is 5 years now?
5 years. Since I'm selling my food and spices since 1999, since I'm in the Cambridge area. Mm-hmm. We just want to bring like a different concept to the, you know, like Cambridge. So
I'm sorry, you can speak
better. Different concept.
We just want to bring like a different concept to it, because we have next door with let's say, next door with the
a restaurant?
Yeah, a restaurant.
Brick and mortar?
Brick and mortar. Upstairs, the one next door to us.
So I love to look like from there, people. Every time we close 10 o'clock the store, I saw a lot of crowd outside. They love to go, you know, the dance or the... So we have feel like we can open a new concept with the food and dance with the pattern. So I think it's a really great idea. We speak to some other customers, they said, oh, why you don't bring the license for the Dosa Factory? So we just feel after Dosa Factory, people, they really love to cook our food. So they can, we can serve the, like, a bowl upstairs.
Do you foresee needing to reconfigure the kitchen for Dosa Factory if that's going to be the kitchen that supplies the food for upstairs as well?
I think we will be the kitchen should be sufficient after we add the space upstairs.
We will also have the kitchen until 10 o'clock at night. So after that,
the other kitchen's open full time now. The second, yes, floor kitchen will be full time the entire time. There's again a lot of prep with Dosa Factory. It's the street food, so it's really prepared. A lot of stuff prepared in advance, and then it's just putting together the plate as the customer orders it. So
you said the Dosa Factory is open until 10 p.m. So then where is the other food coming from?
From upstairs and from the prep areas and things like that. So there's sufficient space based on what they've talked about to the designers, the architects, the kitchen designers, and the like. So there's a certain amount of prepared food that will be stored upstairs. Because it's tapas, it can be plated upstairs as well and served to customers. And they feel there's going to be no lag time or any backup between the two facilities. It's a different type of food, different service as well. So there's different areas of the kitchen that are going to be used during peak hours. They don't feel that they're going to be overlapping one another at any time.
Okay,
square feet of kitchen, which is the size of the kitchen space, so that helps in terms of the kitchen space versus the size of the restaurant. It's almost a quarter to a fifth of the size. So.
Is the management then of this restaurant the same as the one? Was there recently a lawsuit that was settled as it related to, and I know I can't believe everything that I necessarily read, but I think it was regarding wages that were withheld or something along those lines?
I don't know that information.
Actually, you're correct. Yeah, there was something that we went through and gave a square but, in some of them.
Can you tell us about that, please?
I think we did go through that process and we ended up paying and taking care of the issue.
And was the issue that wages were not being paid to workers?
It was paid late. After the whole market crashed and we were trying to keep up on all our businesses and that was the issue. But we did take care of the issue.
Thank you. the road for the full fire suppression system, they're going to sprinkle the building?
Yes, they will put a fire suppression system on the second floor for the restaurant space.
Is the building currently sprinkled? When you say fire suppression, are you talking fire suppression for the kitchen area? Or are you talking a automatic sprinkler system?
I believe the kitchen area downstairs already.
You have the system.
He said that again, I can't hear.
Sorry.
Well, currently the first floor space does have an exit system. And we do propose if needed, we will put one on the second floor as well.
Ansel system?
The fire system.
But what I'm trying to get to is, will the building be sprinkled?
In other words, the Ansel system is for the woods and things.
Ansel is to protect the cooking equipment.
Right. Correct.
That's fire suppression for the cooking equipment. Sprinkler system is for the entire occupancy.
Well, it needed to be.
See, I'm a little bit troubled by it because before the attorney represented that there would be a fire suppression, now you're telling us that if it's needed, you'll do it. So I'm trying to. Is it part of your plans or isn't it part of your plans to sprinkle the building?
Well, what I was trying to get to is if it's certainly needed, then you would go ahead and do the install.
Probably not needed. I guess they're asking you whether you're going to intend to put the complete suppression system.
We do have the intention to do it.
So, going back to this isn't Chief's question, when you say suppression, what do you mean by suppression system? What are you talking about?
No, I wasn't saying suppression, I was just saying
you just said suppression system. So, what do you mean? Just tell us what you mean by that.
No, I wasn't thinking. Not the suppression system, I was trying to use the sprinkler system.
All right, let me rephrase this. So, number one, what's the timeline on the build-up?
You're looking at another 6 months.
Okay. And I assume you are paying for the entire renovation cost is being borne by you and not the landlord?
It's been borne by us.
Do you know if the building currently is sprinkled?
I am not sure.
I am not sure either. It may be, I'm not sure. So I just like the, and it very well may be required because of the occupancy numbers and the type of establishment it is. And that would be addressed in the state building code.
Absolutely. I think in the discussions with the architects and things like that, I think those conversations have come up saying you're likely needed, and of course, I think the responses will put that in. So I think that's maybe the, if I misspoke saying that we'll do it regardless, I don't know if that's the intention or not, but I think it makes good sense, and if certainly they're putting a lot of money and investment into this anyways, they'll probably likely decide that that's a decision to be made.
So in terms of the transfer of the all alcoholic beverage license, can you talk to us about that?
Sure. So the existing licensee is F&B Restaurant Corp. So we'll be coming from 21 Brookline Street to this location, still within the same neighborhood. In terms of I did discuss it the last time. I'll just certainly be help more than. In terms of public need, the current operators, which are Sarabji Pabla and Delvinda Pabla, they run and operate Shalma Foods, Indian Spices, as well as Dosa Factory. These two locations have been combined in business for over 20 years in the city. They have a great reputation for those two businesses. They have run quality business. It's been the patrons of the company, as Sarge referenced before, regarding the service of alcohol for a Dosa factory. The size alone and the type of business they ran at Dosa, it just was not something that was ever, could be a possibility. When the second floor space became available, that's when they started looking into things further. They still have the support of their customers, as we heard the last time, as well as in addition to the Central Square Business Association, that have spoken to their experience and their operation of their past businesses. The alcohol will be a supplement to the food. They're looking to have, as we decided, 70% food, 30% alcohol at this location. SARG will be in the process of getting 21 proof training, as well as crowd management training for this location. All the servers that will handle and serve alcohol will be trained as well. They feel that it's going to be a great addition to this location. There is already two restaurants in the location. Patrons already go down there. They want to make it a whole atmosphere for dining experience for this location. They feel that this is something that the city does not have. It is a sit-down, fine dining, French cuisine with Indian influence. It has not been done, and they feel that there is a trend towards this. There's been customers at Dosa are very loyal. They like to have something in addition to the street food, which is a quicker service food. And again, they've been in business for 5 years. Shalimar Food Spices have been 17 years. So between the two, they have a very large following for the Indian cuisine. And again, they feel that this will be in addition, a good asset to this location. It is utilizing the existing license that had not been in use for several years. They feel that this is the time and the appropriate space to make this happen. Again, as the last hearing we met, there was some neighbors and patrons in support, as well as the business association as well. And I think, you know, they've been there, they've been a long-standing presence in the city, and they'd like to continue to do so and expand the use of space that's not being currently used.
I'm sorry.
Capacity of Man Ray. Mr. Hall, what was your capacity, sir?
850.
Sure, as you can recall as well, and I'm sure Mr. Hahn can speak to it, there were several prior deals that had fallen through, whether it's the location was not quite right or the offer wasn't quite right or whatever. And again, I wasn't present for those, but I was reading back in the minutes. So what we have here is a proven operator in terms of the food operation and also a retail operation, Shalimar Food, that has been in the city, that is accountable, and is looking to add to the ambiance of the city, add to the restaurant scene of the city, and feel that they can do that quite adequately and to the satisfaction of this commission.
Yeah, I think
So what will be the determination on the sprinkler, whether it's going to be...
Well, if in fact the building code requires it, it's going to be, it's going to be a moot point.
They don't have a choice.
And I, looking at it right now without having a copy of the code in front of me, I think it's going to require it. The other thing is, the building may already be sprinkled, I'm not certain. It's easy enough to find out. I have nothing for you.
I'm all set.
Are there any members of the public that wish to be heard in this matter? Seeing none. Once everything comes in order, from what you can tell?
Yeah, except the counsel said that he was going to submit an amendment for the application to reflect that she also had ownership interest. You submitted it for the manager page, but not for the application itself.
I did prior by email to Elizabeth, so it may have been a month or so ago.
Okay, so that's okay.
I found its way, but also it should be in the back of that packet as well. Should be those pages that should be...
Okay.
Supplemented as well. I wanted to bring a hard copy.
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay.
The total capacity is 150, correct?
Correct.
Now, would the DJ and dancing be every night?
No, would not be, no.
Mostly over the weekend, just Thursday.
I mean, yeah, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, most likely. And it would vary, too. In other words, it wouldn't always be one or the other.
Proposed hours of operation are 11 to 1, Sunday through Wednesday, and 11 to 2, Thursday through Saturday. Is that correct?
That's correct. Yes.
And when will food service stop?
Most likely, probably 12 midnight would be food service. Yes.
All during the whole week?
Whole week.
Yeah. So midnight.
Just one last question. I think the placement of it says six TVs. Where are the TVs placed at? According to the floor plan?
Yeah, most of them three of them will be behind the bar area, and then they'll be facing the dining corners.
Kind of out of the way of the dining area, but so off in the bar area itself. Okay. Chair, I did include his school and church as well, which we want to notify in a separate letter or something.
Is that the Henry and Scott
Henry,
School
yes.
and St. Paul?
St. Paul, exactly.
And what about the increase in trash disposal in that area? Is that going behind the building, or?
Yeah, it would be, there's dumpsters right now behind.
Well, yeah, I mean, we still have that issue going on in the city, and we're trying to resolve it.
So, if there's currently an issue already with trash disposal, how is this going to add to it? How are you going to manage it?
Well, what we propose to, the city is that we're looking forward to working with either HMART or Central Kitchen, and they are looking to help us kind of work with them so that we can work with the trash, just the trash aspect of it with HMART, and then the recycling with the Central Kitchen. And it is still in the works.
Parking, street parking, or in the lot behind you, or?
Well, I think most of our patrons are using the lot in the back. We are looking to target a lot of lockers, and that's exactly what we are trying to do with our employees as well, to encourage walking and living close by and using public transportation.
How many staff do you propose to be working there?
I think before they mentioned 10 full-time.
10 full-time is in the building.
10 and 12
part-time. So 10 full-time and 10 to 12 part-time.
And this is not include people who would be also working downstairs at DOSA?
No, this would be a new set of employees for instance.
Managerial staff.
No questions.
And once again, are there any members of the public that wish to be heard? Seeing none. I'm going to make a motion that we approve the application for Dougie LLC doing business as Studio Mantra with Sarah G. Pop-Love manager, with the transfer of the all-alcohol restaurant license currently held by F&B Restaurant Corporation Dog Hall manager with proposed hours of operation, 11 to 1, Sunday through Wednesday, 11 to 2, Thursday through Saturday, with a proposed seating capacity of, is that still 72? 72. That's also with the change of location of the license from 21 Brookline Street to 577 Mass Ave, pledge of license, entertainment license to include dancing by patrons, live musical implementation, DJ, audio tape machine, CD playing music, below, at, or above conversation level, 6 TVs, with the requirement of 21 proof training and a review in 6 months.
Second.
All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Thank you.
Can I just clarify, would that be 6 months after opening?
Yes. Thank you.
Yes. Just for Secretary of Purpose, you don't need 3 separate votes that all encompass for the pledge as well in that?
I did it as all
as one. That's fine. I just want to make sure it was covered in this. Your protocol. I just don't want the ABCC to come back.
Jill, you can just read back and make sure that it was reflected in the vote, please.
What your motion was?
Yes.
Just want to make sure the pledge is mentioned in there.
Would have been toward the end.
Sorry about that.
No, it's fine.
Sure
I'd rather do it while you're here.
I'm sure
so
you said
fine.
It. I just want to make sure.
I think I have to come back yet again.
Oh, I don't
mind. The pledge of license?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, great.
An entertainment license. You read
right.
Pretty right, much
okay.
What was on the agenda.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you.